On the Health Watch tonight, it's believed one Central Coast student may have the H1N1 virus, and now there's a push to try and keep it out of other schools. The sick child is from Carmel River School, but in Salinas, county school officials are taking steps to increase education and awareness surrounding the virus. Action News reporter Felix Cortez has more from our Salinas newsroom.
Well, Aaron, the focus is on students because they have the greatest potential to spread the swine flu.
We are taking it very serious that this year we need to begin early.
Monterey County Superintendent of Schools Nancy Katowski is hoping to prevent an outbreak of the swine flu in public schools by starting early with an education and prevention program.
If you're sick, you don't go to school. You know, you don't go to school, you don't go to work.
Posters are going up around schools encouraging students and teachers to practice good hygiene. And all bus drivers and custodians will be asked to clean a little more.
The doorknobs are being washed, and everything that students do touch are being kept to the highest standards of what we ordinarily do.
And the County Office of Education plans to hold flu clinics in rural areas. There's a chance they might be giving swine flu vaccinations in late October.
Spread with that throughout the county, and really focusing on being able to get the shots to the kids who don't routinely see a physician.
The swine flu may have already made its way into public schools. One student and a parent at Carmel River School are believed to have it. In Monterey County, 38 people have been hospitalized with confirmed or probable cases of swine flu since April. Currently, Salinas Valley Memorial Hospital has 7 patients, and they're all in isolation.
At this point, we're restricting visitors so that we want to make sure that we also are putting safety measures in place for our community.
Hospital and health officials say the numbers aren't alarming, but be warned, you probably should get a flu shot.
What we don't want to happen is you to have your immune system weakened, to be sick with the seasonal flu, and then on top of that, have the potential of getting the H1N1 or have the swine flu. So you want to keep your immune system strong.
And you want to do that by getting vaccinations this year, and that goes for children as well. Aaron?
All right, Felix, thank you. And for the latest health information on swine flu, including a complete list of flu clinics that may be offering the vaccinations, as we said, it's still a few weeks out, but visit our website, ksbw.com.